guys, it's Monica with Scrap Saturdays for part two of my toilet paper mini. And so I've already got one side of my chipboard covered for the front and the back cover of my albums. I like to use the Scotch quick dry glue. I think it works best when I'm trying to glue paper onto chipboard. I try to get as close to the edges as I can. I'm a messy gluer. I don't glue things neatly. And I try to use the tip of my bottle to smoosh, if that's a word, things closer to the edge so you have less lifting afterwards. Now usually I'm bent over my desk while I'm working, so I'm kind of have to do this in a different position to make sure you guys can see what I'm doing. But if you get to see my hair, I'm sorry. So I've got my X-Acto knife because there is a lot of raw edges that I like to trim away. Even by tracing and cutting out. I'm not a good paper cutter. I don't do precise trimming, so I have to rely on my X-Acto knife and my scissors afterwards. But if you're better than me, which I hope that you are, and you can do this neater, then you're just gonna have to be patient while I trim down my excess paper. And happy National Scrapbooking Day. It's still the same day for me. But YouTube only allows me to do 15-minute videos, so hence part one, part two, and part God knows what, how long it'll take me to make this. So I'm not too worried about neatness. I'm just trimming as much excess as I can. I am going to use my sander block to sand on the edges afterwards, so I'm not worried about that. So I think it's just in the hardware section. It's just a everyday sanding block. I'm not being gentle. I'm sanding it very roughly, and if paper is coming up, then paper is coming up. I'm not too worried. I am looking for the very distressed, grungy look, and it's the only way for me to get these edges to be more finished.